Hello. Good morning. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. Today, airlocks. Several people have asked me after my little tutorial on timer blocks how to do the airlock that I had in that tutorial video. Well, we're going to go and take a look at that, how I set it up. Not so much how I built it, but the actual setup. And you're going to need four timer blocks, but I'll show you that through the control panel in a second. We're on board the Vagabond Star, one of my spaceships, and we're going to use a very simple airlock, double door, to get out. And we're in creative... my creative save has been switched over to survival, because to do what I want to do, I need survival mode rules enabled. So, as you can see, we're wasting oxygen there with that, but that's one of the things with those double doors. Here's my little test airlock space station thing, just floating in space. And here's my airlock. Now, I've made a modification to this, and I'm quite pleased with it. You can't get in. It is impossible for you to get in, or anyone else to get out, unless they actually use the airlock properly. So we're going to have to open the airlock. So, here we go. And the same deal applies. We can't get into the main station and vent it without using the airlock properly. Okay. How does that work then? Well, you're going to need four timer blocks. So let's take a look by pressing X on the button panel's control panel. And you'll see that I've hidden all of the blocks apart from the ones that I want to use. So, airlock here is the first step. We want to look at what's on that. And I'll show you that working in a second. It has two things on it, because airlocks can do, or rather air vents can do, one of two actions. And I'll show you. Simply, if we shut this door, because we can activate that door without needing to use the airlock, and press X on this air vent, when the air vent depressurizes, sucks all the oxygen out, your flashing light comes on. When the airlock repressurizes, flashing light goes off. So that's one way of controlling an action of an air vent, which is why I need the game to follow the survival rules, because it needs to know that there's oxygen, proper oxygen, in this room. Let's reopen that. So, that's one part of the airlock. Going in here, looking at the setup actions, going down to the bottom, you'll see that when the airlock is pressurized, the rotating light is off, and the second box means it's depressurized. The rotating light is on. How do we control these airlocks though? With four timer blocks. If we look at the control panel again, you'll see I have a timer block set up for each of the sections I want. For a start, let's look at the open section. You'll see my timer block is called open. Now when that timer block starts, and it only has a very, very short delay. Very, 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 very short delay. You'll see in these actions what does timer block open do? Well, it shuts the airlock inner. That's the door to my left. That is called airlock inner. Always wise to rename the things you want to use. I have airlock inner, airlock outer. It keeps things simple, and if you've got lots of sliding doors, you know which one you're using. Then moving along, it then tells the air vent, called airlock, which is the one behind me, to depressurize. Once depressurized, that will suck all the air out, equalize the room, which means that you won't get cannoned out into space. Then it starts the outer door timer block. So remember, it closes the inner and starts the outer timer block. So we look now at timer block door outer. What's on that? Well, three actions. One, we turn off the inner airlock door. This is to stop people from accidentally opening that door and sending all the oxygen out through the main airlock. Then we turn the airlock on, the outer airlock. This is because eventually that door will be turned off when the airlock's shut. And then we open the outer door. The order of actions here is very important. Put them round the wrong way and that door won't work properly. You have to make sure that you turn it on and then open it. And when you press the first button on this panel, what you want is you want to tell this first button to start timer block open. Right? That's button one, that's button two. You want to tell it to start timer block open. And this is what happens. It closes the inner, depressurizes the room, turns back that airlock on, and opens it. Now we want to look at the close side. This one. This is our timer block close. So on timer block close, we want three actions again. This time though, we reverse it. We make sure our outer airlock is closed. We repressurize the room by turning depressurization off. We then start our timer block door inner. And if you remember from the outer one, this is going to be a reverse of the outer. So on that one, we make sure the delay again is about 4 seconds. You can take it down even shorter if you want. But remember, you'll want it around the time it takes an air vent to depressurize or repressurize, which is around 4 seconds. So, your airlock outer, we want to toggle that block off because we don't want people sending our oxygen out into space. We want the airlock to work properly. Then, we want to turn on our inner airlock door and open our inner airlock door, allowing access to the rest of our station. And again, on our actual button panel, we want to start timer block close, which will trigger our timer block doors again. So if you want to relook at close, this is what close does. It starts our inner door, it repressurizes the room, and it shuts the outer. So when we press this button, it closes, turns it off, turns that one back on, and opens it, and we can have access to the rest of the station. And if you don't know how to use timer blocks, well, my other video that I set this up with shows you how timer blocks work. But this is a basic airlock, and since we don't have mods or scripts, this is the best way of making a proper airlock that will suck all the air out, then open the doors automatically and close them, and ensure that no one can do this unless you actually turn that block back on through the control panel. You cannot open the door accidentally and send all that oxygen into space, or cannon yourself out through the door like a shotgun. Again, we'll go out into space just to see this one last time. And any button panel can be set up to use the airlock. And again, I'm back to the Vagabond Star. And that's my little tutorial on how to use a proper airlock. So, until the next one, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy space engineers, happy engineering. I'll catch you on the flip side. Bye bye for now.